Alright folks, so a really special moment is upon us. My new Hellbenders have arrived from the Fort Worth Zoo in Texas. I've been waiting for these Hellbenders for several months now, planning, getting everything ready, and taking care of all of the paperwork to make it legal, getting the water right, getting the tank right, getting everything just right for these Hellbenders, and now they're here. So let's check them out. Sweet, in a broken box. Oh, I thought that was it. Good one, guys. Yeah, that's the box the Hellbenders came in. Oh, look, they swam away. Good trick, good trick.
Yeah,
you tried.
It was much funnier in our heads anyway.
Yeah, it almost worked.
There you go, sir.
Cool. Thank you, guys.
Yeah.
It's gonna be awesome. I got all of Echo waiting.
Okay.
Got the other GoPro ready. We'll see you guys. Whoa. Precious cargo. That's right. All right. That was a pretty funny trick. Now these guys left Fort Worth, Texas yesterday at about 4:30 p.m. Traveled to Indianapolis, Indiana sometime in the middle of the night, and then flew down to Greenville, South Carolina. Then got put on a truck and traveled through the mountains, who knows where. And we're supposed to arrive this morning between 10 and noon, and it is now 2:53, so it's not as bad as I'd hoped, or I'd feared, I should say, and better than I'd hoped. So here they are. We are now about to see what is in this package. Carefully carry them in. I hear it sloshing in there. Okay, we're here, we have the Hellbenders. Now we need to see what is in the box. A letter from the Fort Worth Zoo. It says on it, Fort Worth Zoo, Hellbenders. I'll look at that later. Okay, nice pack. So this is how they've packed it. Do I see any Hellbenders? Here we go. Oh, look at that, guys. Hellbender number one.
That is so cool.
And he survived the trip from Texas. Or she, we're not sure if it's a male or female. That is very cool. There's two bags, that's good, so it wouldn't leak. Or just in case it leaked, I should say. Okay, now I need to see what the temperature of the water is. Infrared thermometer. 55.6, and the temperature of the tank is 66.1. Wow. So we got about a 10 degree difference. So that means I'm gonna have to add some water to the Hellbender's water to help equalize their temperature. Just gonna take some water directly out of the aquarium. And also I'm gonna be not only equalizing the temperature, but also equalizing the water chemistry. The chemistry in my tank and the chemistry in this Hellbender's water is going to be a little different. And so they'll mix and it will be an easier transition. Okay, that's about all I want to put in there for now. But that also oxygenated the water quite a bit. I'm sure the Hellbender is much happier now. Check him out. Very cool. Go ahead and pull them out of the second bag here. Now the second one. Is it? You checked?
Yeah.
Thank you. All right.
Much bigger.
This one leaked. Oh, this one did leak, and it's leaking really bad. Oh boy. There's a hole in it. Well, luckily, the other bag caught the water. Man, that guy would have died if it wasn't for that second bag. Good job, Zoo.
You're lucky,
buddy. Wow. It's never happened to me before. I wonder how that happened. Let's find the hole. Here it is. So what I'll do is I'll make it bigger, and then I'll let him swim out into the other bag. Okay, he's in the other bag now. Boy, that was close.
Good job.
There's the second one, and it's alive. Excellent. I just wonder how that hole would have happened. I'm going to look inside the box. Why don't one of you guys look inside the box and see if you can find any sharp objects? Because there shouldn't be anything sharp in there at all. Yeah. That's so cool. Oh, he's looking at those fish going, I want to eat you. Very cool.
Wicked.
Yeah, aren't those awesome? So now we just leave them in here, about 10 minutes, letting them get used to this new water temperature and chemistry. Maybe we'll give them about 20 minutes while we go out and work on the solar furnace.
Nice.
And then we will come back and release them. But
two.
Okay, so we're back in here with the Hellbenders. They've been acclimating to their new habitat for the last about 30 minutes or so. And we're going to weigh the first Hellbender. The first thing I'm going to do is let out some of the water. Then we're going to put the Hellbender over in this net. I'm not even going to touch him. I don't really want to. Just to lessen any stress on his body. Now he's in the net. Okay, let me get over here. Okay. Now we're going to weigh the net and the Hellbender. Let it drain just a little bit.
Can they breathe without water?
Not for a while.
Oh, he's coming out.
Oh, he's coming out. Let's stop it right there. It was right at 300. He's in. Here he goes. Film him over there. He is in. Okay, so it was right at 300 grams. So write down 300 for Hellbender and net.
626?
Yeah. 300 for Hellbender and net. And then the net itself is 200. So he's 100 grams.
Finally.
Yep. Okay, the first bender is in. Now let's do the second one. Oh, yeah. Comes our second one. And in he goes. Yeah, he's ready to go. Let's try it down here, hooked to the net. He's about to come out, and it is also 300. Okay, here he goes. Plop. There goes number two.
And then 200.
He is in.
He's just in here.
The net is 200. Exactly. That's amazing. They're the exact same weight. Okay, now we're going to go in to look at the Hellbenders underwater.